All right, hello, all you Merchant Center Mastery people. Delighted to share with you my next video. Gosh, I really got to work on those intros and outros. Google product categories. So that's what we're going to talk today. Google product categories. This is the sort of video that I just love, because what we're going to do is we have different segments of our Merchant Center YouTube channel, and one of those is going to be on the specific feed attributes. And here's the beautiful thing about this is Google constantly changes these feed attributes, but sometimes in very small ways. But you'll go in and you'll read about an attribute and you'll see some different things about that. Let me just shout out Google there. I think that's really cool. We might get upset about them changing things, but what I've found in a lot of these attributes is that they're actually improving them. There's certain feedback. Pricing is a really good example of this. We've given feedback before. I was part of that conversation years ago in terms of communicating. What about, for instance, merchants with MAP pricing, minimum advertised pricing, and how do we process that? Because they merchants with MAP pricing, where that price was crossed out until the correct price got added in the cart, those were typically in the past completely disapproved, and there are ways around that now. So Google's listening to us, and I really like that. Google product category is one of those really interesting attributes that's actually changed, and you might not know exactly why it's changed or that it even changed or how it's changed, or you might just want to learn about it. So that's what this video is about today. It's all about Google product category. Now, Google product category is one of the feed attributes, and if you remember, those are just, think of a feed like a spreadsheet, and it's just the different columns. So one row across is a product, and then the columns are the different attributes of those products, and those align with what Google, the data that Google wants to receive, so they can best match your product up to your target audience's search query. It's really a cool thing. I've always loved Google Shopping for that. So just a refresher on how Google Shopping works, like the better your attributes describe your products, the better you're going to align with the correct searches out there, especially by giving Google the right signals. Some of those attributes you insert unique and custom values for. Some of them, they are what they are. Google product category is one of those where you can only put in what Google wants you to put in. So they have an entire taxonomy of product categories that you can see, and you have to pick one. Now, a couple things about Google product category. Let's go way back in history. So this is 2019. I was looking back into this and I couldn't quite find the exact date. I think it was the end of 2018, if I remember, because I actually wrote a post on this. And it was about 2019. And if I try to follow Google's announcement on this, it's a 404. So, I should try the Wayback Machine for that. Okay. Hold on. I literally just thought of that. Let's try it. There's one right there. There it is. August 12th, 2020. Wait? Huh? We found it. Boom. Thank you, Wayback. Here it is. The 2019 Merchant Center product data specification changes begin March 27th, 2019. There you go. Thank you, Wayback. So here's what's interesting about this. So Google product category used to be a required attribute. You had to have this in, otherwise your products would be disapproved. It is no longer a required attribute, and that occurred. The changes will occur March 27th, 2019. So if you've gotten into Google Shopping since then you didn't even know that this used to be required. I talked to a Googler, a Google Shopping feed specialist, back around this time. And here's what I was told, and this makes a ton of sense to me. So here's what I was told. This is from the memory of a random conversation with a random Googler, so take it as such. Law? Absolutely not. Maybe some good thoughts? Bingo. So what I was told by this Googler is that Google was identifying that their product category system basically had weaknesses. We're actually going to talk about one of those. However Google decides to determine what is in their category, their taxonomy, I have no idea, to be honest. But somehow Google product category determines what product categories they're going to make for their taxonomy, and yet there are limitations. And to their credit, Google actually knows that. They actually see that. So what they started to realize was, hey, the merchant submitted product type actually gives a merchant a merchant's internal signal saying, here's how we categorize our products. They started to realize that that was some really helpful contextual information for getting smart contextual signals to the algorithms to, again, better match your product with the user's search query. And so they kind of, according to this Googler, they kind of started shifting in importance. They decided, hey, the product category still want it in there. It's optional now. And the product type we're going to make a little bit more important on our back end, on the algorithmic side. So again, that's hearsay. It really makes a lot of sense to me because that's also the time where I remember Google starting to push product type more and just how they were communicating. Up until then, if I remember correctly, like Google hadn't really talked about product type at all. And all of a sudden they're like pushing it and bringing that up. I think that's kind of what happened on the back end. Long story short, Google product category is not a required attribute. It's an optional attribute. Now here's part of though why it's also optional, and I think people may not know this, but all products are automatically assigned to product category by Google. So if you're like, yeah, it's optional, I'm not gonna fill it in, your product is receiving a product category by Google. So you are getting one whether you want it or not, right? It's just a matter of if it's gonna be accurate or not. The field that you actually can submit in your feed, the Google product category attribute, you can submit one, and Google says that it can be used to override their automatic categorization in four specific use cases. So first, it can be used for calculation of US taxes, so making sure the correct US tax rate is applied to your product, especially if that differs from product to product. Second, the enforcement of category-specific attribute requirements. Like, basically, if Google screws this up, like apparel or that, then you can make sure that you can override Google's automatic categorization. Number three, Google Ads campaign targeting. Let's say you use product category for your campaign targets. You wanna make sure you put them in the right one. You know, you can override the category for that. And then fourth, alcohol. You gotta get this one right. It's gotta be just right or Google's gonna disapprove that. Their automatic categorization might not do it correctly. And so you gotta make sure that you go in and manually override it. One thing as a brief note on the Google Ads side for campaign targeting, since you know we brought it up right there, here's my thought. Like, I hate when I go into a new account and see that someone is using Google product category for their campaign segmentation. I honestly think that's a bad way to do it. Google product categories have weaknesses. They're just not very exhaustive. Sometimes they're random and they apply in weird ways. Again, like I'm gonna be pushing you throughout this channel always to product type. I'm a huge product type fan. I think product type is one that a lot of merchants miss because it's automatic. Google product category is used almost in a lazy way by people where they're like, okay, well, I'll just aim this campaign at my Google product category. I would say shift your practice in how you're organizing your shopping campaigns to be targeted to product type instead. So it's going to match your internal categorization, your internal nav system a lot more, how your products are actually categorized. We'll get into this in the product type attribute. But a lot of times the reason product types are assigned is for a very specific reason, because there's actually a different target audience, which means you want to bid separately. You maybe want different ads. You want that separate. So get in the habit of organizing your Google Ads campaigns around product type, not around Google products, Google product category anyways.